Hey guys, I'm Dr. Matt Geller. I'm here with Dr. Boyd. You practice at Gandy Eye Care in Northeast Louisiana.
Thanks for coming on. You're welcome.
It looks like, you know, a big part of what you're doing now is multifocal lenses and probably some specialty stuff, but what got you into the multifocal side?
So for me, of course, we learn about multifocals in school, but it just seems more natural than the monovision style. So I think that's what drives me to always start with multifocals.
I remember doing my first multifocal fits and like I would just sweat and be like, what is going on? What, like, they're not happy. Talk us through that. I mean, how do you get through that initial phase of your first couple, it not going right? Calm yourself down.
A huge part of success in fitting multifocals is patient expectations. So you have to walk them through what they're looking at, what they're wearing, what's going on before you even start, so that they know, hey, this first pair that we put on is probably going to be maybe terrible. It might be awesome, but if it is, don't worry. We have lots of other choices. We're going to get there. Just be patient with me. So what I explain to the patients first is, one, like I said, it's not going to be great the first time, but I also explain the lens design. So always explain that multifocals either have a center distance or center near portion, and outside of that is concentric rings of the opposite. So if it's a center near, there's a ring of distance near, so forth and so on. That way they kind of understand what's going on. And I say, so normally, you know, when you were 15 and you had eyes that could focus a lot, when you looked at something up close, all the light from everything else was not bent perfectly onto your retina, but that was. With these multifocal contact lenses, whatever you're looking at is going to be bent perfectly onto your retina, but so is everything else. So what that means for you is when you look at something and try to focus on it, it may be a little shadowy, fuzzy, but those are all things that we can adapt to and get rid of. So it takes time. Some people's brains adapt super quickly. You have 2 days and you're like, oh man, this is the best thing that's ever happened to me. Some people, it's 2 weeks, it's even longer, but be patient, we'll get there. And if we don't like them, we'll find something else.
With technology like that, I mean, that's pretty innovative. Is it changing the way you're planning for the future around contact lenses? Do you see more innovation coming from, you know, once products like this are coming out and really showing to be successful?
Obviously, the more options in contact lenses we have, the more patients we can fit in them and the more demographics we're going to cover as far as who wants to, because you may even have patients that don't necessarily need contacts, but perhaps they are a competitive snowboarder, or maybe somebody that wakeboard, you know, some extreme sport that glasses get in the way. I think it would definitely be great to have some kind of contacts, even if they don't have a prescription.
We're always looking for industry to help us serve our patients better. I mean, you can't be back there doing R&D yourself. So these things need to come to market for you to help more patients. And so I think this really helps the category.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, thank you so much for coming on. I really appreciate it. I hope to hear more from you on the topic.
For sure.
Cool. All right. Thank you again.